friends, welcome back. It's story time again. Today I'm going to read the story Rapunzel by Harry Lee Robinson and Martin Impey. Rapunzel is locked in a tower by a wicked old witch. There is no way to escape until a prince comes riding by. Will Rapunzel and the prince ever get away from the witch? Let's see what happens by reading all the story. Once upon a time, there lived a beautiful girl with long golden hair. She was called Rapunzel, after the plants her mother loved to eat. A wicked witch had stolen Rapunzel when she was a baby and hidden her away at the top of a tower. The tower had one small window and no door. Rapunzel was trapped. She could not escape. She was so bored that she sang songs all day long. The witch visited the tower every day. To get in, she would scream out, "Rapunzel, Rapunzel, let down your hair." Then Rapunzel would let down her long golden hair. The witch would climb up and get into the tower through the small window. One day, a prince rode by on his white horse. He could hear singing. He looked up at the tower and could hear Rapunzel's beautiful voice. At once, he fell in love with her. The prince hid behind a tree and watched. He saw how the witch climbed up the wall and got into the tower. Later, when the witch had gone, the prince called, "Rapunzel, Rapunzel, let down your hair." The prince climbed into the tower. He told Rapunzel that he wanted to save her. As they talked, Rapunzel fell in love with him. Over the next few days, when the witch was away, they planned her escape. The prince brought her a bundle of strong silk and Rapunzel spent many hours making a ladder. Before long, she would be able to climb out of the tower and be rescued by the prince. But when the witch next came to see her, Rapunzel made a big mistake. She forgot that the witch did not know about the prince. Rapunzel cried, "Why are you so much heavier than the prince? He can climb up my hair quickly." The witch flew into a rage. She was so cross that she cut off Rapunzel's long hair. "And to make sure he never ever finds you again, I'm going to hide you somewhere else," she searched. The witch left Rapunzel deep in the dark wood. Then the witch went back to the tower. Later that day, the prince rode up to the tower. He called, "Rapunzel, Rapunzel, let down your hair." But this time, when he climbed up the tower, he saw the angry witch. "Away with you," she cried. The prince fell into the sharp brambles and thorns at the foot of the tower. The prince's eyes were badly scratched by the thorns. He could not see. For two long years, he wandered blindly, lost in the woods. Until one day, he heard beautiful singing. "Is that Rapunzel?" he whispered. "Is that my beautiful Rapunzel?" he cried with happiness. Rapunzel cradled the prince in her arms. Her tears of joy dripped onto his eyes. The prince found that he could see again. The prince led Rapunzel away from the woods to his place. The wicked witch was never seen again. They lived happily ever after. About the story, Rapunzel is a German fairy tale. It featured in the collection of tales by the Brothers Grimm in 1812. The story of a maiden in a tower can be traced as far back as a story from Persia, modern Iran, written in the 10th century. In the Brothers Grimm version, Rapunzel's father is caught stealing a Rapunzel plant for his pregnant wife from the witch's garden. He only escapes with his life by promising to give the witch his newborn child. Now, let's begin the story. Imagine you are Rapunzel when you have just given away the secret of the prince to the witch. What will you say to the witch to convince her not to punish you or the prince? Now imagine you are the witch. What will you say to Rapunzel? That's all for today. See you in my next video. Bye bye, friends. Stay safe, eat healthy. I'll come back with another story.